Hi there. Let's talk about choice and choosing. This is a topic that comes up quite often, the notion that there is no choice, there is no free will. And so the question is, usually put, is there free will or is everything already written, already determined? The answer is no to both. The notion of free will is a movement of thought energy arising as apparent choices, choosing. Choosing certainly happens, doesn't it? I mean, the appearance of choice happens virtually at every instant, whether to go left or right, whether to have steak or salad. To choose is simply a thought energy that arises, and this is where it gets tricky, after the so-called choice has already been made. Neuroscience has proven that thoughts, even including choices, decisions, all of that, arise in the brain a moment before the brain cognizes them. They arise in consciousness, rather, a millisecond, a split moment before the brain even recognizes that there is a thought there. Whether the thought is a choice or whether the thought is an idle thought of, you know, I wonder when she's coming home or whatever the thought might be. So this business of choice gets very, very tricky in the expression of non-duality, because the assumption of choice includes necessarily the paradigm assumption of a me who can make some choice, make some effort to choose, some decision. So, you know, we kind of undercut that here by saying, well, look, have a look, see if you can find a chooser. So, in fact, choices seem to occur, and the chooser seems to occur after the fact of the choice, but it's always after the fact. It's a commentary on what's already happening. The happening of choosing is simply another happening in the presence of awareness. And prior to the presence of awareness, there is simply the absolute in which there's no choice, no chooser, no time, no space, no location. There's not even no thing in the absolute. No thing, or pure consciousness, is an arising phenomenon in the noumenon of the absolute. So what's shared here is pointing back to the absolute, which is prior to, prior to, prior to, prior to. And when that is seen by no one, then it becomes absolutely clear, obvious, and self-evident that everything is everything. Can anything be excluded from everything? If there is only everything and the absolute, and they are not two, then where's choice? Choice is part of everything. Choice and chooser are part of everything. Nothing is excluded from everything. That does not mean that nothing is excluded from everything. It means that everything is included in everything, including nothing. So you're not going to understand or grasp this. In this message, understanding is the booby prize. To grasp this like a concept and to take the concept on as a new belief turns this message into a new, sort of new agey religion. Pardon me. And this religion of Advaita is very much not what the message is about. This message is absolutely incomprehensible and unfathomable, and yet there is a certain energy, a certain aliveness that is arising that propels the sounds out of this orifice through this organism pattern of energy with a name and a form. But this pattern of energy, name and form is nothing but the absolute in drag. You are, as I am, the absolute in drag. But the absolute in drag, it's kind of like, you know, the whole drag queen thing, that the guy wearing the clothes is still a man, whether he's dressed as a woman or not. You know, that's the irrefutable So if an organism is programmed to be a man, it's going to be a man regardless of what clothes it puts on. In the absolutely the same way, the absolute is the absolute regardless of the clothing that it wears. The clothing that the absolute wears is what we call the universe, phenomenality. So in this phenomenal appearance, there is the noumenal absolute, and the absolute and the relative in this are not two, not separate at all. So what could possibly be separate from everything? You see, even the notion of, quote, I am separate, unquote, is simply the absolute appearing as that notion. So what's wrong with that? Nothing. There's nothing wrong with anything. Everything is simply exactly the way it is. Haven't you noticed? Everything is exactly the way it is. That's just the absolute appearing as exactly everything, exactly the way it is. And this is aliveness. And just that. Aliveness is the expression or the manifestation of the absolute. The absolute noumenon actualizes as the apparent phenomenon, to say it in fancy words. But, you know, fancy words or not, the simplicity of it simply can't be denied, and that is the essence of being that you are, which is irrefutable and inescapable, and that is described in language as I am. But notice that language itself is the expression of the absolute as relative, the absolute appearing as relative. Nothing appearing as everything is one way to put it. Nothing being everything is another way to put it. But everything is everything, is it not? Of course. So seeing that ends any seeking and ends suffering. The pain of an organism may still arise. This is an old thing with pains. But there is no suffering. Suffering is simply the commentary about pain that says this is my pain and I don't want it. But see, the paradox is even that is a languaging of the absolute. Now what we don't notice is the context language. Without the space called language, there couldn't be any languaging. And the space called language is unique to human expressions and is the perfect, absolutely perfect expression and manifestation of the absolute. So what's the point of all this? No, there's no point. This is just a sharing. It came up to sit down and talk to a camera as though there were people out there. And now maybe there are people over there looking at this image and saying there's something over there. But there ain't no out there. And for you, there's no here, there, or there, here. There's only here. And everything is happening here. Aliveness. Just that. So the pointless point is, you are that. Aliveness. And even before that, the absolute essence of absoluting, absolutely, absolutely, absolute. What is absolute is absolute. So, aliveness appears as the perfect expression of the absolute in all of its forms. All of the light and shadow, the play of consciousness appears as the perfect expression of the perfect absolute in you. My friend, are that. And that's that. Thanks for watching. Cheers. I love you.